Hey, Alma's Recipe here. Welcome back to my kitchen. Today I'm going to share with you guys how to make cocktail de camarones, also known as shrimp cocktail. And it's very good to this time of summertime because it serves cold. So, vamos a empezar! You will need 1.5 pounds of shrimps, 6 cups of water, 1/4 of onions, 2 bay leaves, 2 garlics, and 1 teaspoon of salt. 1.5 cups of ketchup, 1/2 cup of orange juice, you can use fresh or store bought, 1 teaspoon of Maggi sauce, 2 chile chipotles, 1.5 cup of the broth that we're going to cook the shrimps, 4 limes, 1 cup of celery, 1 cup of cilantro, 1 cup of purple onions, and 2 tomatoes. Optional to serve, you also need some avocado, crackets if you like, or some chips, and either one works. And salsa valentina or tapatio, I don't have tapatio, but you can use either one, or any salsa you like for topping. I'm gonna preheat my water medium heat, and I'm gonna add 1/4 of an onion. I'm gonna add 2 bay leaves, 2 garlics, and 1 teaspoon of salt. And we're gonna let it boil. Also, I'm gonna cover so they can start boil soon. From there, we're gonna go moving to peel our shrimps. Let's talk about the shrimp. You can buy on peel already or on peel. I buy it still with the skin, so I'm gonna peel it, and that's the reason why. I'm gonna show you as we go. But either one works, so if you don't want to peel it, just buy it with no skin. So vamos a empezar. The first thing I'm gonna do is by taking all the skin first, and I'm gonna save the skin for a reason. And you'll see when I'm almost done. I already also wash it. Make sure you rinse it out first because we're going to use the skin and everything. So we're gonna peel first every single one. And also too, when you buy it and peel, it's a little cheaper too. If you wanna save some couple pennies or not. But it takes a little bit more time too. And if you don't have a lot of time, just buy it already peeled. But I also wanted to teach you another trick. Sometimes when I already peeled all my shrimps, and sometimes they have like the gut. So with a toothpick, we're gonna just put it in here, and then we're gonna pull it, you see that? And that's how you're going to clean it. That's very easy, so we're not using that part. So now I'm just gonna do to every single one from the back and pull it right there. And that's it. My water is boiling now to this point. The reason that I bought the shrimp with the skins is because I'm gonna cook the skin for 5 minutes so they can give it more flavor. You don't have to, this is optional. If you don't wanna cook it, that's totally cool. You see how this one turned good? So I'm just gonna let it boil like for 5 minutes. And then we're gonna remove it. And if you buy with no skin already prepared, to this point you do the second step, but I'll show you when we come back. I've been cooking my skins for 5 minutes, so to this point I'm just gonna remove it with everything. This one is really easy to remove it. So I already made my broth, so that's what I need. I'm just gonna cook my shrimp for 3 to 5 minutes. They cook really quickly as soon as they turn pink. You don't wanna leave it too long because they no good if you leave it really long time. So this one just need very short time to cook. So in the meantime, my shrimp's cooking. I have water here with ice. It's very important because we wanted to stop cook them. So it's important, cold water with ice. You just wanna cook it until they turn pink. So mine take a little bit less than 3 minutes, so they're already done. And to this point, I needed to transfer to cold water before they start turning rubbery. So I'm gonna move my pan right here. And the only thing that I needed is to move my shrimps and put it here. That will stop from them to be continue to cooking. So we're going to save that one for make our sauce. So that's also our broth. I have my shrimp in the cold water with ice, and I also can use 1.5 cups of this one, but I also want it cold, so I wanna pull it right out on my measure cup, so that way they will start cooling down when we need it. So in the meantime, we chop our vegetables and everything, that will be cold. So I'm gonna start by chopping my celery. I need 1 cup, so let's just chop as many as until we have a cup. We wanted to chop it in a very fine little pieces. We don't want it too big because we don't want to have a junk, so as fine as we can. I have my cup of celery and just gonna put it in here. So now I'm gonna start with my onion. So for my onion, I'm gonna start cutting this part first, then cut it this part also too, then cut it in half. I think I'm gonna cut it this way. And we also want it really fine too, so we don't want a big chunks, as fine as you can. Mm-hmm. So I have 1 cup of my onion, just gonna put it in there. So, and I have a little bit left over, so I'm just gonna remove it because I don't need this one no more. I can use it later on when I cook and not something else. Make sure you already wash everything. I already washed my cilantro really well, so you wanna make sure also to you wash it well. So we also need 1 cup. Make sure you wash it and then you dry it so you don't have a lot of water. Fold it and do it like that. Break it in half. This is 1 bunch. I think maybe 1 bunch will be plenty for do the 1 cup. And we're gonna do also fine too, really fine too. So now I'm just gonna make sure that I have my cup of cilantro, and I think I do have my cup. So that's what I need. I'm gonna just put it in there. For now, I'm just need my 2 tomatoes. I already rinsed it out too, so I'm just gonna place that, and I also wanna cut it in small pieces. If you don't like any of these ingredients, like if you don't like tomatoes or you don't like celery, you don't have to put it in. It is also 1 cup of tomato. That's what it makes, 2 tomatoes, medium tomatoes. So I'm just gonna put it in there too. Also, I'm gonna be working on my avocado. I'm not gonna cut in 2 right now because I'm not gonna use them all right now, but I'm just gonna cut 1 to prepare it. Because this is gonna be in the topping when you serve your cocktail. And probably I'm just gonna do like a little squares, just gonna peel it, and they won't come out really beautiful. Sometimes they don't come, but this is absolutely gorgeous. So what I'm gonna do with this one, I'm just gonna cut again squares, and I'm just gonna put it in this bowl. If you're gonna eat everything in one time, you can put the avocado, so that I don't put it right now everything because I know I'm not gonna eat it everything in one shot, so that's why I'm gonna put it as I'm using it because the avocado do turn black. So I give you the option to use 1/2 cup of this one or 1 orange. We need 1/2 cup of orange juice, so I'm gonna just use real orange because I have it and they're so beautiful and it's much better to do fresh. But either one works. So I'm just gonna take the juice out of this one and hopefully this one will make 1/2 cup. And it's very close to 1/2 cup. It still need a little bit, but I think it'll be fine. And that one is like a medium, like, well, it's kind of big orange. But you can use 2. Close enough, so it's perfect. So now I'm gonna start with my limes. Sometimes I'm just gonna roll, see maybe they can give me more juices. But this one, again, I only need 1/2 cup too. I have my 1/2 cup of limes, so it's perfect. So 4 limes will be perfect. So now that I have my lime juice and my shrimps are cold, so I'm gonna pull my shrimps out of the water and I'm gonna put it in this bowl. So we don't longer need that water, we just need the shrimps. So now that I have my juice for the lime, so I'm just gonna put it in here. And I'm just gonna let it sit over here until we make all the ingredients. Doesn't have to be very long, but that's what I'm gonna leave it here. So I don't only need that one, so we're gonna be moving, preparing our sauce. So I'm gonna start by blending my chile chipotles. Look, and I only gonna use 2. This one is kinda like has a really good flavor. It's kinda like smoking flavor, so it's gonna give you a really good flavor. So I'm just gonna put it here. And I'm gonna blender, and I am going to blender with the orange juice because I don't want to put anything else that I don't use it. So that's how I'm gonna blend it. 1 teaspoon of Maggi sauce, just gonna put it in there, and I'm just gonna blend everything up. So I'm gonna put my ketchup in here so I can start blending everything together. 1 1/2 cup of ketchup and 1 1/2 cup of broth from the shrimps. We just kind of wanted to mix, we're not going to blend it really a lot, we just wanted to combine all the ingredients together. So we're going to, basically, we're going to start very slow, gentle. And that's it. So now to this point, I'm just going to put my sauce in here. It has very good consistency, as you can see, it's not like really water, but it's a little thick, so that's what we're going for. To this point, you can taste it, but I think it's pretty good. To this point, I'm just going to add all my ingredients. My tomatoes, my cilantro, my onions, and my celery, and I'm just gonna stir until I combine everything together. I have my shrimps here, so this is the last part to water with my lime, so I'm just gonna add everything here, and we're just gonna just move everything to everything incorporate together. And that's pretty much it, guys. So we're gonna bring it back into the refrigerator for at least 20 minutes so all the flavors combine together, and then we're gonna come and serve one. I'm gonna take this one to my refrigerator for 20 minutes and let it chill out, and then it'll be ready to serve. My cocktail has been chilled already in the refrigerator for 20 minutes, and the only thing left over is to eat it, just making and enjoying. We're just gonna serve it, and we're just gonna put it in here. You can put as many strings you want or as little as you want. And the last thing that we're gonna do is just put some avocado here. Right there. You can enjoy it with crackers. This is optional because it already has the chile and chipotle. But if you wanted to just eat some of this one or any salsa you like, you just put some of that and it's ready to eat. That's it for this video, guys. Hopefully you guys give it a try. It is very delicious. If you guys went to a party and wanted to bring a dish, this one would be really good. A lot of people like shrimps, and hopefully you guys try. I also have an Instagram that my daughter make. My name is Ama's Recipe, so I'll have the link in the description. Hasta la vista!